Hey y'all, today I want to talk about breakfast. That's because when I often start working with somebody, that is the very first thing that they want to talk about. When I talk about the list of things that are really smart choices and nutrient-dense choices and the things that we probably want to avoid, the very first question is, then what do I eat for breakfast? Because what we often eat for breakfast are things like yogurt and granola and pancakes and bagels and cereal and toast, all of these things that really are not nutritious and they're just really not as dense as other things we could be eating. And honestly, it's a myth that those are the breakfast foods. There is really no such thing as a breakfast food. It's just a thing that we've decided to eat for breakfast. You could, in fact, eat cereal for dinner or pancakes for dinner. We just usually choose to eat those things for breakfast. So I challenge you to think outside the box a little bit and bring things into breakfast that you might not normally. But really, first and foremost, you can actually bring back foods that used to be staples at breakfast, which are eggs and bacon. Those are really great nutrient-dense foods. And when you eat those eggs, eat the whole egg. The yolk is wonderful. There's so much nutrition there. And when you choose your bacon, choose high-quality bacon. Don't choose maple-flavored bacon. That's not the same thing as a really good quality apple-smoked bacon. As long as you're sticking with quality, eggs and bacon can be a great breakfast. But it's not the only thing. Again, breakfast is, there's just this myth of what breakfast foods are. You can, if you had steak and green beans for dinner last night, you can have those for breakfast the next day. If you want to make them a little bit more breakfasty, you could cut up the steak and scramble it in with some eggs in the morning instead. Add a little bit to that. You can also have a salad for breakfast. I know it sounds weird, but there are some days, especially here in Texas in the hot summer when it's like 110 degrees at 8 o'clock in the morning, I have a salad because it's nice and cooling. I could also add some eggs and bacon to that salad to, again, make it feel a little more breakfasty. But honestly, at the end of the day, that is just a time of day that we have decided to associate with certain foods. You don't have to do that. And if you want to get nutrition at breakfast, you gotta eat nutrient-dense foods, which does mean that you're gonna be eating vegetables and meat at breakfast. Not a bad thing. It's a little bit of a mental game you kind of got to get over, but I challenge you to work on it. And I promise you're going to find lots of things you can eat for breakfast. Mix it up. Throw some avocado in there. I love pickled jalapenos on my eggs. It's really, there's a lot more to eat than we think there is. Give it a try. Thank you so much, and I'll see you next time.